Gosh, I don't even know where to begin. It's graduation day, a day to celebrate our achievements, a day to thank the people that helped us succeed. I've sat and stared at my computer screens for hours trying to come up with the right words to adequately give this speech. But as I stand here today before all of the highly esteemed leaders of the class of 2016, moms, dads, siblings, grandparents, faculty, guardians, aunts and uncles, I feel unable to give you the thank you you all truly deserve. How do you tell your mom that you have no idea how she put up with your mood swings over these past 4 years and that you are beyond grateful for that? How do you tell your dad that he's been your knight in shining armor? How do you tell your brothers that even though you want to run them over with your car 97% of the time, that you would do anything in the world to see them happy? How do you tell your grandparents that you've learned charity and the ability to care so deeply because of them? How do you tell the teachers that have taught you that you've learned so much more than them teaching you A squared plus B squared equals C squared? Yes, Mrs. Pelletier, I remember calculus more than I want to. It's almost impossible to do all this, but I'll try to give it my best shot here. So, to the teaching faculty and staff, thank you. You've basically been our parents for the past 4 years. Some of us have sat in your room and cried, some of us have fought with you, and some of us avoid you at all costs. But in the end, you've helped guide us to become the young adults we are today. I can honestly say from the bottom of my heart just how thankful I am, at least, for your guidance. Teachers, you've inspired us and encouraged us to be the best. We are blessed to have been taught by you. Please know that we will leave Fort Kent Community High School today prepared and ready to offer the world the skills that you have taught us. You may have the title of teacher, but to many of us here in the class of 2016, we consider you part of our family. And to our siblings, you've listened to our ranting, our crying, and laughing. You've taught us that sometimes we just need to let things go. For our older siblings, you are our role model. All my life, I've tried to be like my older brother, Alex. Even though I hate to admit it, you were the reason I tried so hard. Brothers and sisters, you've taught us that it is possible to get through high school. You've taught us that even when things don't go our way, there's always a way to fight through it. You've taught us how to love and protect our family. Micah, my baby brother, you may say that since you're taller than me, you're more mature than me, and tougher than me. Real funny kid. It stinks now that you have your license and we don't ride to school together for those 3 minutes in the morning. I will forever cherish those times. I'll probably miss my little brother more than life itself when I leave for college. Younger siblings always have a way of having our backs no matter what. You may be younger than us, but you've had an equally important impact on our lives. Siblings, you've kept us sane so far in this life. We couldn't have done it without you. Dads. The men who taught us that family is everything. You live, breathe, and bleed family. The rock of our lives. Personally, every time I was hurt, my dad ran to my side as quickly as possible. Whether that meant driving to Holton with your four ways on, or supporting me in the challenge to walk again, you were always there. I'm sure most of our dads have done the same for us over the years and will continue to do so. Our dads have showed us a father's support should be unlimited. You never expected us to be the best, but you expected us to do our best. You taught us that even though we may have a bad day, we're allowed to give ourselves the day, feel sorry for ourselves. But you also taught us that we have to make tomorrow better. You have taught us not to let a bad day turn into a bad week to turn into a bad month. You taught us that everything is a war, and even though you lose the battle, the war is not over. And finally, moms, in my case, my best friend. You taught us how to be sympathetic. You taught us how to be charitable. You taught us unconditional love. You pushed us to be our best. You taught us never to settle. You taught us that we can achieve anything. You taught us how to pick ourselves up off the ground even when we fall. You taught us to endure the worst. You taught us that even though we may not be rich with cash, we are rich in so many other ways. We are rich because we have family. We are rich because we have a support system that allowed us to succeed. I know teenage girls can be moody, but somehow you kept us grounded as much as possible. Mom, our car rides to Bangor, Portland, and Boston will forever be my favorite time spent with you. You were there for everything. You taught me that sometimes we have to make sacrifices for one another. Life isn't going to be easy, but we do our best to keep fighting. We all have our own story, our own happiness, and our own pain. You've taught us to be empathetic and charitable towards others, and that we can't live in our own little world. You taught us to do the right thing. You've helped us become the men and women we are today. And as we stand here today, we hope we have made you proud. We hope we give you every reason to look up at us and smile and say, that's my girl, and that's my boy. And of course, a thank you to all the other leaders that have helped us get to this point. So as I end this speech, I would like to congratulate everyone that has helped us get to this point. Teachers, administration, guardians, parents, siblings, grandparents, aunts and uncles, and community members. You are the reason we are graduating and ready to head off into this scary world with the tools necessary to succeed. In a world where ISIS, Ebola, and the next presidential election are all solid threats, we have the power to go out and make a real difference. Class of 2016, let's show the world what we're made of. Let's be the class that actually makes America great again. Over and out.